I noticed from looking at your filmography that you have been not only doing Justice League since 2001, but you've also been doing a number of video games, including most recently Elder Scrolls.
Right.
And can you tell me what it's like? What's the difference between working on a show like Justice League Doom and working on something like Elder Scrolls?
Elder Scrolls, I had a lot of different sessions for it.
Mm-hmm.
It was such a huge game. Huge. They were recording all over the world for that game. So this I did in a day, and then I had another day of recording for ADR for all the action stuff. But I worked by myself in the video game, and for Justice League Doom, I was in a room full of people. Not the leakers, but a room full of actors.
So when you do stuff for Justice, when you're working on Justice League Doom, what's the work environment like? What's your day like?
You get up, you're a little nervous, you know, you're going into the studio, you're excited because you're going to be working.
Uh-huh.
And then you have Andrea there, Andrea Romano, and you have Bruce there, and you've been with them for a long time. So it's uh-huh. At this point, it's a very comfortable experience. The group reads through the script, we do a rehearsal, then we record it, and then we'll do pickups, and it's a great day. You know, it's a great day. Very lucky.
So do you spend a lot of time working on your interpretation of the character with respect to, the continuity of the character with respect to the storyline and how you express that, the character arc from the beginning of the story to the end?
Yeah, I work on the script a lot at home.
Uh-huh.
And so I'm really, really, really familiar with the story, with her lines. And then when I get into the studio, then I can work with Andrea with the vocal piece. And but when I'm reading the script, I tend to find her. You know, she's there. The way she speaks, the formality to her.
Well, and so much of that is you bringing that into the role.
That's very sweet. That's very sweet.
And you really, I think it's fair to say that you define the role. So.
Thank you for saying that. That's very sweet. I hope so. I want to at this point. I feel very proud of her at this point.
I think you should. I think it's a masterwork. I think it's. I'm sort of speechless myself.
Okay. Let's do it. Before I get totally embarrassed, let's move on.
So, yeah. So, you've worked on so much stuff. Like the Jack games, you've done television since 1993, and you've done an awful lot of voice work, as contrasted to being in front of the camera.
I don't do on camera.
Oh, you don't do on camera?
No, in fact, I did one. I got into the union through an on camera job.
Mm-hmm.
That I worked for a lovely man who put me in his movie, and that was fantastic. But I've always preferred to be in front of a microphone rather than being on camera.
Uh-huh.
And so there's just a comfort in front of a mic because of my background. So, yeah, I don't do that. So those are the only credits you'll see are the voiceover
credits.
So that's, yeah.
Well,